Hey everyone, and thanks for dialing in today. Welcome to ReThink OT Dailies, 5-minute messages to renew the OT mindset and reignite your passion for the profession. I'm Michelle Eliason, and I'm a neurocentric occupational therapist and the creator of geriatricoccupationaltherapy.com. Let's jump in. Today's topic is life space. In the next 3 or 4 minutes, we will be hitting 3 points. 1, what is life space? 2, what does it sound like when someone is shrinking their life space? And then 3, what can you do to help your patients maintain their life space? All right, what is life space? Webster defines life space the physical and psychological environment of an individual or group. Because we are generalists, we are able to evaluate the individual's personal factors, environmental factors, and occupational factors. This is why life space is so important and why every OTP should have an understanding of it, along with environmental stress and the ecological theory of aging. Life space. In terms of physical environment, this includes specific rooms within the home, the area immediately outside the home, and the neighborhood and town. Life space has a tendency to shrink with age due to functional limitations caused by physical and cognitive changes during aging. As people age, health decline can influence the ability of an older adult to remain independent in their home. When someone's health is declining in any way, chronic health disease, cognition, muscle endurance, physical activity performance is also affected. 2, what does it sound like when someone is decreasing their life space? It sounds like this. I'm less steady carrying my laundry up and down the stairs. I need to bring my bedroom down to the first floor, so I don't need to keep climbing those stairs. I am not going to the beach this year because I don't feel safe walking on sand. I try not to leave the house more than once a week in the winter. I'm struggling with numbers lately. I'm not going to play cards anymore. I don't want anyone to notice. My daughters pick up my groceries because I have a hard time carrying them. I only shower once a week because I don't want to get into and out of the tub. I would rather be by myself today. I can't keep up with my grandkids anymore. I forget more things and become easily confused in places that should be familiar. The same can be true of the psychological factors of life space. Older adults may face psychosocial changes such as depression, fear of falling, mood changes, and reluctance to be independent at home. This ultimately leads to reduced life space. Psychosocial and perceived motor elements are just as important as a disruption in physical space. A decreased life space, for any reason, will ultimately affect functional mobility, physical health, mental health, cognition, well-being, and the body's ability to meet the demands of environmental stressors, usually resulting in long-term care of some kind. 3, how can occupational therapy practitioners help community-based adults maintain their life space? Well, here are some ways. 1, include a life space inventory self-assessment in your comprehensive evaluation process or intake. 2, help your client find activities and modes of transportation to ensure the maintenance of life space. 3, take time to address the psychological factors that may have led or will lead to a disruption in their life space. 4, advocate for the maintenance of life space to your clients, caregivers, and other professionals by using research-based concepts and theories. Understand the ecological theory of aging and environmental stress theories, and understand the importance of finding the just right environmental modifications to enhance independence and also maintain a body's functional capacities. This balance is so important. Well, that was short and sweet. I think I've hit all the points. For the transcript of this call, head to our website. That's all for today. Thanks for listening. For more information, check out geriatricoccupationaltherapy.com. Talk to you tomorrow.